Congenital heart disease is the most common birth defect. Every year in the United States, hundreds of babies' lives are saved through newborn screening for critical congenital heart disease. Early detection of life-threatening heart disease before these babies leave the hospital is crucial. This video will provide clinicians and medical staff with comprehensive instructions and an in-depth exploration of how to perform a proper screening for critical congenital heart disease, or CCHD.
Hospitals have been screening for critical congenital heart disease using pulse oximetry in the United States since 2011, resulting in improved health outcomes for these newborns.
Pulse oximetry, or pulse ox, is a simple, painless, and non-invasive test that measures oxygen saturation of hemoglobin in the arterial blood. It is recognized to be a safe and effective tool for identifying infants with serious heart defects.
Congenital heart disease, or CHD, impacts roughly 8 per 1,000 infants. The most serious form of critical CHD impact roughly 3 per 1,000 infants born. Screening for CCHD saves hundreds of infant lives a year in the U.S. Leading health organizations around the country and around the world have endorsed critical congenital heart disease screening. An early analysis found a decrease in infant mortality rate of 33% in CCHD cases and 22% in CHD when newborns were screened for congenital heart disease in states where the test was mandatory. This association was not seen in states who had not implemented mandatory policies to screen at that time.
Recent updates to the screening algorithm have been recommended by the American Academy of Pediatrics. These changes make it easier both to perform and interpret.
Pulse oximetry screening for heart defects has been a game changer. This newborn screen allows us to better detect babies with serious heart conditions who were not detected before birth. The overall goal is to get them to early treatment. Pulse oximetry screening results are best when paired with prenatal ultrasound during pregnancy and clinical examination after birth. Combining all three strategies can capture up to 98% of infants with critical CHD.
If Charlotte didn't have this screening, the chances of her being here today would be very slim. Something so simple as a pulse ox test to be able to look for something that could be life or death for your child.
Critical congenital heart disease screening can identify over 12 critical cardiac conditions. Pulse oximetry is increasingly valuable, not only in its ability to identify infants who have heart conditions, but also in its detection of important respiratory and infectious illnesses impacting newborns.
The heart on the left represents a structurally normal heart. This child would have a normal pulse oximetry screen. That would be above 95%. The heart on the right represents one type of CCHD. The abnormal structure allows oxygenated and deoxygenated blood to mix. Oxygen saturation would then be detected by pulse oximetry. While not all heart disease presents with low saturations, pulse oximetry screening helps us identify many at-risk infants. Babies with critical congenital heart disease may be well appearing with no visible signs or symptoms of CCHD, such as murmur, cyanosis, or tachypnea. Failing to detect CCHD while in the newborn nursery may lead to critical events such as cardiogenic shock or death. Survivors who present late are at greater risk for neurologic injury and subsequent developmental delay. In the past, we had been teaching pediatricians to go into the newborn nursery and to simply look for cyanosis. The human eye really can't see that cyanosis until the oxygen level drops to about 80%. So when babies have saturations from 80% up to 95%, nurses and pediatricians often can't see that cyanosis. Those babies may get discharged if not screened.
Research studies conducted in both the U.S. and around the world have shown us that pulse oximetry screening improve safety for infants born with heart defects and that we can make a difference. No member of the clinical team wants to discharge an infant with an undiagnosed heart defect. Pulse oximetry screening gives us one more tool to identify and intervene early. Evaluating a baby's blood oxygenation level prior to discharge just makes sense. We want to understand why a baby may not have a normal oxygen level prior to leaving the hospital.
CCHD screening should be done around 24 hours of age or just prior to discharge if an early discharge is anticipated. Waiting until 24 hours of age allows for the transition from fetal to newborn circulation to occur and will decrease the number of false positives. We measure the oxygen level in the baby's right hand and one foot. If you are using disposable pulse oximetry sensors, use a new sensor for each infant. If you are using reusable sensors, clean the sensor with the recommended disinfectant solutions between each infant. Dirty sensors can decrease the accuracy of your reading and can transmit infection. The best sites for performing pulse ox on infants are the palm of the hand and on the foot. Substances such as dried blood can affect the pulse oximetry reading. An infant, not an adult pulse ox clip, should always be used for infants. Place the photodetector portion of the sensor on the fleshy part of the outside of the infant's right hand or either foot. Place the light emitter portion of the sensor directly opposite the photodetector. When placing the sensor on the infant, there should not be any gaps between the sensor and the infant's skin. The two sides of the sensor should be directly opposite each other. Secure the sensor to the infant's hand or foot using the adhesive or foam tape recommended by the vendor. It is not recommended to use the silk tape or your hands to secure the sensor. If the baby is moving, shivering, crying, cold, or in a deep sleep, the reading may not be accurate. Swaddling the baby and having a parent calm the baby during the reading can be very helpful. Remember that pulse oximetry readings aren't instantaneous and that the reading is an average. If the oxygen saturation is greater than or equal to 95% in both extremities and a difference of less than or equal to 3% exists between the right hand and the foot, then the baby can go on to receive normal newborn care. If the oxygen saturation is less than 90%, the healthcare provider responsible for the infant's care should be immediately notified and the infant should be examined. If the oxygen saturation is between 90 and 94% in either extremity, or there is a difference of 4% or more between the right hand and either foot, then the test should be repeated 1 hour later. If the baby has another abnormal screen after 1 hour for a total of 2 screens, the baby should be referred to the responsible healthcare provider for further assessment. Once the oxygen saturation level is determined for both the right hand and one foot, the screener will determine based on the protocol whether the infant needs additional testing or if they pass the screening. If the pulse oxygen level recorded is lower than normal, the baby will be re-screened. Sometimes babies take time to adjust to breathing outside the womb. If the oxygen levels are still not normal, with the help of the clinical team, we determine the reason and the next course of action.
Babies who have a failing screen should undergo prompt evaluation. That testing not only is looking for CCHD, but also needs to consider the possibility of infectious diseases or problems with the child's lungs. We need to perform a complete echocardiogram, especially if those other tests do not show an obvious cause of the low oxygen saturation. By assessing both infectious and respiratory causes of low oxygen levels first, infants may not always require a full echocardiogram. The test positive rate, or number of infants who fail the screen, is between 4 and 5 per 10,000 infants screened. When these babies are assessed, We know that in addition to detecting infants born with a CCHD, we may find other non-cardiac causes for low oxygen levels.
Parents should be educated about CCHD screening during prenatal tours and classes, at OBGYN clinics, and through hospital education.
It's very important that parents understand that this test will identify many babies with CCHD. However, it will not detect all babies who are born with CHD or critical forms of CHD. Families should be educated on the signs of congenital heart disease, which may include blueness, lethargy, and difficulty feeding or gaining weight. No screening can catch all heart defects or other issues. If an infant displays signs and symptoms of critical congenital heart disease, they should consult with their pediatrician.
So, in addition to other newborn screens that many people are familiar with, like the heel stick and the hearing screening, we think that CCHD screening fits in nicely because we can save babies' lives, and that's huge.
Our goal ultimately is that no baby with critical congenital heart disease will leave the nursery and not be treated for a condition in which we have excellent results.
We want all clinical providers of newborns to understand the importance of this CCHD screen.
CCHD screening using pulse oximetry improves outcomes through timely detection and saves lives.
To learn more about critical congenital heart disease screening using the pulse ox test, ask your health team, and you can visit these resources.